In episode 58, we built an EV3 modular robot, which actually is an updated version of this robot. In the next few minutes, I'll point out some of the disadvantages of this construction and take you through the process of improving it till we reach the construction from the 58th tutorial. I found this EV3 construction on the internet and it's quite a good start for your robot. Still, there is a space for improvement and we'll begin with the back wheel. As you may notice, it is quite unstable and this is due to the fact that it is attached to with just these two pins here. This makes the weight falls on them and makes the whole construction unreliable. What I'll do is that I'll use the back wheel I showed you in episode 58, where the weight falls on these three beams here and is equally distributed onto the back wheel, which makes the whole construction more reliable. So now I'll change the two back wheels and then we will continue with examinating our robot. Okay, so now I have attached the back wheel and I have used this red pin with stop bush to lock the back wheel and now it is quite firm. So I'll continue with examinating the front wheels. As you see, they're quite loose and this can cause errors while the robot is making turns, which can cause problems if you want to orientate your robot on the field. A good technique to solve this problem is to build an outer frame which will hold the axles on which the tires are attached, and in that way you'll make your tires stay firm. The problem with this technique in our case is that if I build such outer frame, the robot will get too wide and this can cause problems when you want to maneuver through the field. That is why I will have to think of a way to narrower the construction, and in our case the best way to do so is to flip 90 degrees this frame here, which will allow you to have your motors closer one to another. So I'll disassemble the construction and flip the frame and then we will see what we can do next. Okay, so now I have disassembled the construction and the first thing that I have to do is to move this black pin one hole up, because from this side the frame do not have holes here and here. So I'll attach the frame. And also one other small issue that I would like to solve in the process of flipping the frame is the attachment of the two sensors. Currently it is quite strange as you see, and I personally do not really like it. So I have built this thing here and the sensor will attach into these two holes like this. So now I will do the same thing for the other motor and the other sensor and then we'll continue. So I have attached the two motors and the two sensors and now I can continue with assembling the medium motor. Till now the medium motor was attached to the frame on just these two pins, which makes it unstable. Which as a whole is not a problem, but after all we want to attach attachments to the third motor, which will make the whole construction to take a load, and so it is better if it is stable. That is why I will use these T-like beams, and through them this will allow me to have two pins, one here and one here, for attaching the motor to the frame. So now I'll attach it. So now I have these four blue pins with which I'll attach the medium motor to the frame. So it will go like this. And we have the medium motor attached. Next I'll stop on these two beams. They will make hard to attach any gears to the medium motor and that is why I'll detach them. But when I do so, the front shield will fall. That is why I'll take these pieces off and I'll use these angled beams. So I'll attach them here and on them I'll build on the front shield. Another plus of these angled beams is that here I'll have holes where I could attach some additional attachments. So now I'll build the front shield. Okay, I have built the shield and I have built these two things here in order to make cover of the light sensors. This will not allow any outer light to be detected through the light sensors, and this will make them more reliable and accurate. These angled beams here I'll use to attach the outer frame, and this one here will use to attach the shield to the base of the robot, which will make it stronger. So the shield goes into these pins. Okay, and now I will focus on the back frame. The back frame looks like this, but now if I try to assemble it, it won't fit. That is why I will have to flip this frame 90 degrees like the front one. And when I flip it, I'll continue with building the robot. Okay, so I have reconstructed the back frame. I have flipped 90 degrees this frame, and I have added these two beams of length 3. So now I can attach the back frame to the motors. Okay, and we have our base construction ready. Now I have to attach the brick, and here a simple problem that occurs is that after I have flipped the two frames, now here it is a little bit higher than here. So I'll have to add a beam here like this and then to attach the brick. So now I will attach this beam to the frame and attach the brick. And then we will continue with the outer frame of the robot. Okay, so now I have attached the beam to the frame, and I have used long pins in the back so that the pin will go further into the brick, and this will make the connection stronger. So now what I have left is to attach the brick. So first I attach the back here, and then I'll attach the four pins in the front. Okay, now I have to build the outer frame. The outer frame should be connected here to the front shield and here to the back frame. And also it should be connected to this axle so that there is a point in building outer frame. So now I have assembled the outer frame, and we will see how it looks like. Okay, so I have finally reached this construction for the outer frame, and I have made symmetrical for the other side. I will use these two black pins to attach the frame to the motor. This one will attach the frame to the front shield, and in the back I will lock the frame with these two red pins. So it should be assembled like this here, and the key feature is that the axle, this one of the tires, goes into this hole here, so like this, and now the tire is more firm than the other one. So when I lock the frame, you could see this. So here and here. Okay, so now I will repeat the same procedure for the other side, and we will finally take a look at our assembled robot. So finally, we have reached the construction from episode 58. In one of the future tutorials, I will improve this construction even further, like using less blue pins or make it a little bit more stable. I'll be really glad to see any improvements done by you, so keep commenting below this video.